Well, as temperatures begin to fall and we experience our first cool change of the season, minds are already turning to the threat of a power shortage this winter. The state's new energy minister warning of the challenges in securing supply.
An autumn chill over Lake Liddell, signalling the coal plant which has fired the state for a generation, has weathered its final summer.
In 18 days, the Liddell coal-fired power plant will close.
Cameras allowed inside last month for a rare look at the station running on borrowed time, its life extended just to get us through the hot months. But in over 2 weeks, the turbines will stop turning, 1,200 megawatts of baseload power to be stripped from the grid as winter looms.
But what it really does highlight is the challenges that New South Wales will face when it comes to energy security and energy transition in coming years.
After Liddell, the nation's biggest power station, Eraring, is scheduled to close by mid-2025, followed by Vales Point by the end of the decade, with coal plants in Victoria and Queensland due to come offline as well. The closures have prompted fears of energy shortfalls, putting the new state government on tenterhooks. Premier Chris Minns has even floated buying back Eraring to keep it running longer. In the long term, renewables will fill the gaps, the federal government having doubled approvals for new clean energy infrastructure since it was elected.
We're getting faster, clearer decisions for businesses that are keen to invest.
An interconnector running from South Australia through Victoria and to New South Wales, among the projects greenlit.
Creating a pathway for these states to share and exchange energy.
The distant future mapped out, but there could be a few road bumps along the way. Liz Daniels, Nine News.